Wake up, everybody, no more sleeping in bed. No more back thinking, time for thinking ahead. The world has changed so very much from what it used to be. There's so much hatred, war and poverty. Wake up, all the teachers, talk to teacher new way. Maybe then they'll listen to what you have to say. They're the ones who's coming up, and the world is in their hands. When you teach the children to jump the very best they can. The world won't get no better if we just let it be. Na-na-na-na-na-na-na. The world won't get no better. Gotta change it, girl, just you and me. Wake up all the doctors, make your old people well. They're the ones who suffer and who catch all the hair.
Good morning.
They don't have so very long before their judgment day. Won't you make them happy before they pass away? Wake up all the builders, time to build a new land. I know we could do it if we all lend a hand. Only thing we have to do is put it in our minds. Surely things will work out, they do it every time. The world won't get no better if we just let it be. Na-na-na-na-na-na-na.
Welcome to the class.
Change it, yeah. Change it, do it alone, do it alone. Need some help, go, go. Do it alone, do it alone. Yeah, yeah. Wake up, everybody. Wake up, everybody. Need a little help, y'all. Yes, I do. Need a little help. Say it for me, so help, y'all. Gotta change the world. What it used to be, yeah. I'm going alone, going alone. Need some help, yeah, need some help, yeah. Wake up, everybody. Get up, get up, get up, get up. Get up! Wake up! Come on! Come on! Wake up, everybody! Teach a new way! Maybe this is the song what you have to say. Wake up, everybody! No more sleeping in bed! No more about the thinking! Come on, thinking.
Welcome! Read directions in the chat box and on your screen. Welcome to class. Please read the directions in the chat box. We're going to get started in 60 seconds, so please make sure you have that text open. Welcome to class. We're going to start in 30 seconds. Make sure you're following the directions. Welcome to class. We're going to start in about 20 seconds. Make sure you're following the directions in the chat box. Thank you to the 5 students who have gone into participants and indicated that they have their text open. Thank you so much. All right. It looks like 9 of our students have clicked yes, that they have opened their text for today. We're going to go ahead and get started. Make sure your text is open. All right. So let's go ahead and launch with our Ignite quote for today. Okay. Reading is a basic tool in the living of a good life, is today's quote. So I want you to think about this quote. We are going to dig a little bit into a new text about how we learn to read so that you can pull some evidence for your new essay this week. So think about this quote: reading is a basic tool in the living of a good life. And then answer these questions. Under what circumstances do you agree with today's quote? Under what circumstances do you disagree with today's quote? Please be sure to include a personal anecdote to support your thinking. I'm going to go ahead and start looking at responses. And once I see that everyone has begun, I'll mute myself so that you can focus. We have 5 minutes for this work. All right. I need 9 more students to get started in Pear Deck, please. I need 6 more students to get started in Pear Deck, please. I'll put the code back in the chat in case anyone coming in late needs that. Thank you for those of you letting me know what's going on in the chat function, so helpful. I need 3 more students to get started in Pear Deck. I need 2 more students to get started in Pear Deck. Still waiting for 2. If you have a technical issue, please tell me in the chat box. All right, I'm gonna start reading and giving you feedback. All right, I'm reading through your responses and all of you are taking positions, which I really appreciate. Some of you are saying, yes, I fully agree with this. Some are saying, under some circumstances, I do. Now what I need you to pull in is a personal anecdote that supports that thinking. So connect it to your own lived experiences. When has reading been something that was totally necessary in your life if you're saying you agree? Or when has it not if you're saying you disagree? We have, 90 seconds, so not fully 2 minutes, 90 seconds left. Take 30 seconds to wrap up your response. All right, sorry for not giving you that usual 10-second warning. We're going to go ahead and move to our goal for today. So today, what we're doing is we're going to identify and discuss how our brain can interact with text in order to improve our reading comprehension. We're annotating with comment boxes and collaboratively discussing and selecting evidence in our breakout rooms. So today it's a brand new text, so we will focus on the reading part of the work, but tomorrow we'll return to the exact same text and we'll dig into analyzing it. That's why today we're at identify and discuss. Tomorrow we'll move on to analyzing interactions. Why are we doing this? I got through reading all of your outlines and I was so excited to get to know you more as I was reading through your outlines. And I noticed that we needed some additional evidence. And so I pulled some texts for this week that will help us support our evidence selection. So as we revise our outlines and finalize our essays this week, we will want to include evidence from this text, especially when when we're focusing on the concepts of reading, which will enable us to have varied evidence. A lot of us right now are citing just evidence from our Hammond text. We need to have varied evidence from multiple texts. So I'll introduce you to three more texts today that you could pull in, or this week that you can pull in. So here's our first goal, is to engage with the first two paragraphs of this text. You've done this reading protocol before, so it's nothing new, but as a reminder, you'll stop at the end of each paragraph, you'll summarize the information, and then you'll also add a connection, one of the four options. You don't need all four connections. Please go to participants and click yes once you have this text open. So please go to participants and click yes once you have this text open. Thank you to the students who have already responded. Please click yes once you have this text open. 13 students, thank you. So again, please go to participants and click yes if you have this text open. This is going to be in our Schoology class in week 3 in Wednesday, and it is entitled How the Brain Learns to Read. Okay, 18 of us have said that we have our text open. I do have 22 students here that need to respond. If you're having a technical issue, please put it in the chat box. Otherwise, I'm hopping into your documents now to give you feedback. We have 9 minutes to read these two paragraphs to summarize and make connections. Go ahead and begin. I'll be giving you feedback in Schoology. please go to participants. And if you have summarized paragraph 2, click yes. Click no if you haven't. So please go to participants. If you've summarized paragraph 2, click yes. Click no if you have not. Responses from everyone, please. Thank you so much. I have 16 responses. I appreciate it. I have 18. Need 4 more. All right, thank you so much. That is helpful. All right, it looks like people are now reading and annotating paragraph 2. I am putting comment boxes in. Make sure that if you get a comment box, if there's a question, that you answer it. If it's a statement of like, you're good, this is correct, you don't need to answer it, but with a question, make sure you respond to revise your thinking. All right, it looks like people have summarized paragraph two. If you're not done with paragraph two, we will come back in just a moment, but I do want to move us along in our slide deck. So please go into your slide deck, into our Pear Deck. Once in Pear Deck, please click yes in participants. Once in Pear Deck, please click yes in participants. Thank you to the 10 who have responded. Thank you. Once back in Pear Deck, please click yes. Just waiting for three more students to respond. All right, so we're gonna keep reading in the same text and we're gonna move to paragraphs three and four. If you didn't summarize and make a connection for paragraph two, that is a key paragraph. It's more important to read paragraph two and three than it is to get to paragraph four. But if you can get to paragraph four, that would extend your thinking. So now you're gonna move to paragraph three and four. Start by summarizing. So as I'm looking at people's responses, I'm getting summarizing or I'm getting evidence. I don't want evidence yet. We'll go on to that step next. First, make sure you understand the text by summarizing the paragraph. Then make the connection based on one of your four connection options. So you can say how it connects to something you already know. You can state an idea in the paragraph that's muddy to you. You can state a concept from the paragraph that resonates with you, or you can ask a question that you hope to discover as you continue reading. We have 10 more minutes to finish reading these two paragraphs. I'll continue to give feedback within Schoology. Go ahead and keep going. For paragraphs 2 and 3, please ensure you have a connection. Those are the two most important paragraphs in this excerpt. So make sure that you not only summarize, but you make a connection, knowing that if you activate background knowledge, you're more likely to retain the information you're learning. All right, I have given everyone feedback, and I even see that some people have gone in and responded to my comments. Thank you so much for revising your thinking. I'm going to pause you here. We will come back to paragraph 3 in a second, but I'm going to pause you and send you into breakout rooms for a moment, okay? So let's get ready to discuss All right. So based on paragraph two, what are the three ways to support reading comprehension? Based on what I saw in your annotations, all of us have found at least one of these. Some have found two and some have found three, but we need to make sure we find all three of them. So I'm going to send you into breakout rooms for 3 minutes. And in that time, I want you to discuss the three ways that we can improve reading comprehension. So please click yes as soon as it prompts you to join a room. 3 minutes. Go ahead and click yes.
Can you guys hear me?
Yep, we can hear you, Valeria.
We are discussing the three ways that the three, let me find my notation.
Yep, so if you look at the Paradox screen, it's what are the three ways that you can support your own reading comprehension or that teachers can help you support it?
Oh, okay, so for me, I found
What I said it was instruction of words to the point of fluency.
Maybe actually paying attention to the text, like not just skimming through it. I know there's been times where I'd like read and I have to reread over and over again.
Hi, everyone.
Hey.
So what are the three ways that we can improve our reading comprehension based on paragraph two? So who can give me just one?
When I said was prior knowledge of the reading topic.
Yep, so one of the things is just like how much information is already in your brain about that topic. So if you're reading about baseball and you know a lot about baseball, you're going to understand it better. If you don't know a lot about baseball and you're reading about baseball, you're going to have a harder time. So that's absolutely one of them. Daisy, Tanea, Nicole, or Jade, what's another way?
I said learning words with the definition.
Yeah, so knowing what words mean, and that connects to a concept called fluency. Can someone add on to what Tanea said around like word recognition and fluency? What is that?
Well, I mean, if you don't like understand what you're reading, you're not going to understand nothing, the whole text in general.
Yeah, if you can't recognize the words and pronounce them either verbally or in your brain's working really, really hard just to break the words apart, and so you're not going to understand the text itself. So fluency is the second one. So we've said any prior knowledge you have that you bring to the text, fluency is number two. What's the third one? What can a teacher do before you read a text to help you?
Explain what it's about.
Yep, give you an intro to like what is this text going to be about. It helps you build your schema or build your background knowledge that you can bring to the text. So keep talking. I'm going to go ahead and end breakout rooms in 60 seconds. All right, welcome back. We're just waiting for everyone else to rejoin. Thank you for that discussion.
Now that we've read an annotated paragraph two, we've had a little discussion about it to make sure we're understanding. We're going to dig back into paragraphs three and four, and then we'll have one more discussion before we wrap things up for the day. So what I need you to do now is go back into paragraphs three and four, and I'll start going in and giving you feedback. Class ends in 12 minutes. So this means that you have about 8 minutes to read, and then we'll have a couple of minutes to discuss. Go ahead and get started. Click yes once you're back in your text. So go to participants and click yes once you're back in your text. Just so I know you're ready to go. Go to participants and click yes once you're back in your text. 18 of us are ready. Waiting for a few more. All right, I'll be hopping into your text and giving you feedback on your summary and connection for paragraph three. All right, I'm going back into your documents. I see that some of you have revised your thinking for paragraph two if I gave you a question, and some of you haven't. So if I gave you feedback for paragraph two, please be sure you respond to my comment box so that I know you've revised your thinking and so that I can ask you another question if you need to revise further, okay? Take 60 more seconds to finish your reading, and then we'll go into breakout rooms for 3 minutes, and then we'll go over homework in our last minute. So 60 more seconds here. You ready to share out of the two ways that people can help them read, help themselves with reading comprehension based on paragraph 3? All right, we're gonna go ahead and hop into breakout rooms for 3 minutes, and then we'll wrap up. So in your breakout rooms, you are going to discuss the question on the screen. What are the two ways that readers can derive meaning from a text? Okay, the two ways. Let me just get these going. All right, sending you in, please click yes so you can immediately join, and I'll pull you back in 3 minutes. Go ahead and join. Click the yes, hop right in. All right. All right, welcome back. We're just waiting for everyone to rejoin. As you wait, please read through the homework slide on the screen. Make sure you're in Pear Deck reading through that. Waiting for just a couple more people to rejoin, and then we'll go over this, and then we'll be done for the day. So again, as we wait for our colleagues to rejoin, please go ahead and read through what's on the screen.
Miss.
Yes, ma'am.
You know how you said we had to revise our outline yesterday?
Yep.
Well, I didn't revise it because it was submitted, and I couldn't unsubmit it because you were still going over it. But however, can we add more, another piece of evidence from this reading?
Oh, I love that question. So two things. One, I went through and I manually unsubmitted everyone's outline. Everyone has a grade. Everyone has feedback. So I've gone through and made sure everyone has that. It should be unsubmitted now. I'm sorry that that was like a step in Schoology I wasn't aware of. So thank you for your patience with that. And two, yes, you should be pulling in new evidence. A lot of the feedback I gave was, hey, you need more than one text to be cited, and you're missing some evidence around reading and writing. And so I've selected three texts this week that you'll read and hopefully pull more evidence in so you have a fully fully relevant and fully varied evidence, which is the requirement.
Can we leave our old evidence?
Sorry, Daisy?
Can we leave our old evidence?
Yep, if it was irrelevant, I gave you a comment box saying delete this. If it was relevant, I didn't mark it. And so evidence you currently have, you should keep as long as I didn't say delete it.
Okay, sounds good. Thank you, Miss. I'm sorry.
You're good, Daisy. I'm sure those were questions everyone else had. I know we're at time, so I'm just gonna quickly read over the slide. Here's your homework for this evening. You need to go to Schoology, go to our course, go to quarter one, go to week three, go to Tuesday, yesterday's date. You need to open the outline feedback and read my feedback for the context and evidence section, which is highlighted for you. Then you need to open the rubric for the final essay. This is a similar rubric for the outline, but slightly different. So you do need to open and read and annotate the context and evidence section. Kicker, there's a strong correlation between the students who fully read and annotated the rubric for the outline and got better grades. So make sure you know what I'm asking you to do. Don't guess. Take a look at the rubric. Then open your outline and edit, revise your context and evidence to move yourself to the next letter grade. That's our time. I know you have to get to math. Have a great day, y'all. Bye.
Bye.
Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye.